Welcome everyone to our Debating Development podcast. We have a packed show for you today with tips from our resident concern debates experts, Leanne O'Neill and Emma Hassard, on how to prepare for your upcoming debates year and what the new debates year will look like. Welcome, Emma and Leanne.
Hi, Olga. Hi, Leanne.
Hi, Olga. Hi, Emma.
So, Leanne, we have the school's web registration open for any school wishing to partake in the programme this year. And the closing date is in September. What is the procedure after that? What should the teachers do after the web registration closes and their school was successfully accepted into the programme?
So after you've been accepted, you'll get a contact from Concerned Debates. And then we recommend getting a team together. So you have to have a minimum of 4 students, and we recommend between 4 and 8 students on the team to include some researchers as well. So these have to be senior cycle students only. After that, we will contact you in relation to trainings. So we'll have teacher trainings and student trainings, and they'll be online and in person.
Brilliant.
There'll be a host of materials to download and share with the debaters on the website. So just visit Concern Debates and you'll see lots of materials there. We'll also send them out through emails. You'll receive research links with your fixtures. So you'll be given, you'll be told if you're a proposition or opposition, and you'll be given research links for both. So you'll get to see what your opponent will also be researching, and it's just a jumping off point. So these will be emailed to you along with your fixtures. There's also loads of debates online. So if you look up Concern Debates on YouTube, you can see loads of old finals and there's the best examples and you can take some tips from those speeches. Then you will be asked to register for the Concern Debates platform, which we will go into in further detail. You then have to collect consent forms. So it's really important that we have consent forms for safeguarding, as it's a priority for the Concern Debates team. So you need to send them back to your Concern Debates contact person or email debates@concern.net. So check the dates for your debate fixtures, and if they don't suit, please email debates@concern.net.
Brilliant. Perfect. Thank you so much, Leanne, for all the great tips. So for any teacher wishing to register their school for the debates programme this year, please visit www.concern.net or email debates@concern.net for more information. So Leanne, what will the debate structure look like this year? While we still emerge from living with COVID-19 within our communities, will the debates take place in person or will they take place online?
So this year, it's going to be a bit of a hybrid system. Mm-hmm. The league phase will start in October and run until the end of December. Each school will have 3 debates. These debates are going to be online and you can record them at any time throughout the day, and you'll be doing it on Zoom with the other school that you're against. And then after Christmas, we will pick the top 64 schools and we'll go through the point system later on, but there'll be a knockout system after Christmas, and then those debates for the first 3 rounds will take place online, and the quarterfinals, semifinals and final we hope to have in person.
Brilliant. And may I just point out the fact that you mentioned 64 schools are progressing forward. This is the biggest amount of schools moving forward from the league phase from what I'm aware of. That sounds absolutely amazing.
Yeah, very exciting.
Okay, thank you, Leanne. It looks like it will be a fantastic year with the highest number of schools allowed forward after the league phase. So that should be really interesting to see. And a lot of opportunities for the teams to partake in debates and practice at becoming better debaters. Okay, and a lot more debates for adjudicators to adjudicate for our volunteer adjudicators. So that's always a bonus. Okay, Leanne, can you please elaborate on the point system? What will be a unanimous win or a loss, a majority win or a loss, and will there be any draws this year?
So there won't be any draws this year. When an adjudicator marks a debate, they'll be giving a marking sheet and they fill out the form, and then at the end they will get a score. And there can't be any draws for the way the system works. Okay. So at the end, one school will win and one school will not. And there's a number of different ways that you can win. So to work out who wins, the adjudicators will tot up their marks and then they'll be given the scores. And if a school wins by 20 points or more, they will receive 5 points. And that's a unanimous plus win.
Okay.
If a school wins by 11 points up as far as 19 points, they will then receive 4 points. Okay. And that is a unanimous win. If a school wins by 10 points or less, then that's 3 points. and that's a majority win. And if a school loses by 10 points or less, they will receive 1 point. If it's a unanimous plus loss or a unanimous loss, then the school will receive 0 points. But if they lose a minority loss, it's 1 point. There will also be some byes. So if a school, for some reason, cannot participate in the debates, the school they were supposed to debate against will receive 3 points. But the concerned debates team will make our best effort to rearrange the debate so that every school does get to debate. But sometimes that happens. So okay. At the end of the league phase, the maximum amount of points you could have is 15 points. And then that is how we decide who goes through to the knockout stage. So you can receive 0 points, 1, 3, 4, or 5 for your debates. And at the end, the top 64 schools will then progress to the knockout phase.
Brilliant. That sounds very exciting. And it sounds like it will offer the schools better chances at debating. So there will be a difference. And with the fact that there is a plan to mitigate the amount of buy points for schools, that will probably make a massive difference to schools that otherwise wouldn't have had the chance to face off their opponents. Thank you so much for all that information, Leanne. So, Emma, please tell us what will happen with the debates that take place during the league phase. Will they take place on Zoom, Microsoft Teams? And after the league phase, what happens with the debates?
Okay, thank you, Olga. The concerned debates team will send the list of league phase fixtures to all the schools at the end of September, as Leanne has already mentioned. So the fixture list will indicate who you're debating against, mm-hmm. what side of the motion you're debating, and have the contact details for the opposition teacher. So if you are the proposition school, you are responsible for arranging and recording the debate online, as well as uploading the recording. So as the proposition debates mentor, first you must contact the opposition teacher to arrange a time to record the debate. And with the league phase online, this can be absolutely any time during the day, so it's whenever suits you best, so it's very flexible.
Brilliant.
You then set up the recording, and this can be done via Zoom or Microsoft Teams or any other online platform that you're familiar and comfortable using. And then you send the link to the opposition debates mentor. When the big day comes and you're getting ready for your debate, both schools must record the debate.
Okay.
This means we have a backup recording in case of any technical difficulties. The proposition school are responsible for providing a chairperson for the debate, and we have a really helpful sample chairperson speech available on the Concerned Debates webpage. Both the proposition and opposition schools have to provide a timekeeper in the room, and the timekeeper will ring the bell at 3 minutes and again at 4 minutes and 15 seconds. They complete the timekeeper sheet and will inform the chair of any time penalties at the end of the debate. There is also a timekeeper guide available on the Concerned Debates website, which has further information on the role and the timekeeping sheet. So after the debate is complete, the proposition school must upload their recording onto the Concerned Debates platform. And this platform is a bespoke, secure online platform designed by the Concerned Debates team. And we have a video which takes you step by step through the process of how to use the platform, and also a helpful how-to guide available. For all these resources, again, please do refer to the Concerned Debates website. And don't forget, we do plan to return to face-to-face debates after the league phase is complete in the new year.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for that, Emma. It sounds like a very flexible system for the schools participating. Can you tell us what the adjudication process will be like this year?
Yes, certainly, Olga. So once the video has been uploaded, you will receive an email acknowledging that has been received from the Concerned Debates team. And this is where our team of experienced and trained adjudicators come in. So our adjudicators are committed volunteers who have been Garda or Access NI checked and have completed our adjudicator training. They come from a variety of different backgrounds and varied interests, but they all have in common the ability to judge a debate fairly, without bias, and to competently and reliably score each debate according to Concern's comprehensive marking sheet. So for more information on the adjudicator role, please see the adjudicator information and the associated videos on the website. The team will then notify the one allocated adjudicator that the video is ready to view. Each adjudicator is manually assigned a suitable debates, and on the secure platform, they can only view those specified debates. So it's a really secure platform. Adjudicators will then be asked to mark the debates within a 1 week period. If there are any unexpected delays, the Concerned Debates team will inform you as soon as possible. Results will then be emailed to both schools with our comprehensive feedback sheet and scores allocated to both teams. For face debates, we do aim to have three adjudicators at each debate again. And we do not share the detailed marking sheet with schools, but please do get in contact if you would like any further information, and we are very happy to provide that.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for that. So, okay, we'll move on to a few top tips that you, Leanne, and you, Emma, could offer the schools for the teachers and for the students. So, Leanne, I'll ask you first, what are your top tips for teachers?
For teachers, I would say double check your fixtures just to make sure that you can definitely make all the debates. And if you can't, please contact the debates team at debates@concern.net. Make sure that you check all your emails. There is a lot of information coming at you, but the Concern debates team should have all the information there for you, so you know when the programme starts and the next steps are happening. Check the Concern debates website for all the resources that you might need.
Brilliant. Thank you so much. That's really helpful. And Emma, I'll move on to you now. What are your top tips this time for students?
Thank you, Olga. I would say there is a lot of false news and being spread around on some of the topics that link to the motions this year. So do remember to stop, think and check. So look at where the source is coming from. Is it someone you know? Do they have a source of the information, or are they just saying information that comes from somebody else they know? So a lot of the false news being spread around is from people claiming that messages of a friend of theirs. So do have a look, use your common sense, do a Google search and see if information is being reported elsewhere and seems accurate. Secondly, get the whole story, not just a headline. A lot of these messages are very vague information and don't mention specific details. So this can often be a sign that it's not reliable or accurate. And finally, again, remember to go to Concern's research links for the motions. These are available on our website and also will be emailed to your debates mentor. And you can always contact us at debates@concern.net if you'd like any further information.
Brilliant. Emma and Leanne, thank you so, so much for offering the time to provide this information to the students, to the teachers. Much appreciated, and I'm sure it's going to be used accordingly once the debates kick off. So thank you to all for listening. We hope you tune in to hear the next episode on www.concern.net or on the Concern Worldwide YouTube channel or SoundCloud by typing Debating Development. Follow us on Twitter, Concern Debates, or on Instagram, Concern Active. And if you'd like to get any additional information in relation to our debates programme, please email debates@concern.net. We would also like to thank IrishAid for all the support offered to the Concern Schools programme. And I will finish off, as in the previous podcast, with the words of one of our founders of Concern Worldwide, Father Angus Finucane, who used to say, "Do as much as you can, as well as you can, for as many as you can, for as long as you can." Thank you all. And until next time.